Hi, I'm Dr. Todd Cooperman, president and founder of ConsumerLab.com, and I'm here to talk to you today about coconut oils, both virgin coconut oils as well as refined, as well as MCT oils, which are basically further refined coconut oils. Going to tell you about the differences. We recently tested all of these products and compared the amounts of medium chain triglycerides found in them, or MCTs, because these MCTs are in coconut oil, but you can basically make products that are really more focused on just the MCTs. Now, the MCTs are a type of triglyceride or fat. Fats are basically a glycerol molecule attached to three fatty acids. These fatty acids vary in size. The ones that are medium chain size are the MCTs, and they are caprylic, capric, and lauric acids. Lauric acid is the largest of the three, and some people feel that it acts a little bit more like a long chain fatty acid than a medium chain. What people believe about the medium chain is that they can be converted a little faster into energy, less likely to become fat. And so it's coconut oils and MCT oils are used in dieting, and they're also used they've been tried in a number of other conditions, including Alzheimer's disease, fat wasting diseases, etc. The results are really mixed, I would say, in terms of whether it really is effective or not. However, great amount of interest in these products. So we wanted to know, how do they vary and differ? And all of this is in our report online for our ConsumerLab subscribers at ConsumerLab.com and our coconut MCT oil report. So I just want to tell you kind of our general findings here. First, for the coconut oils, and these are the virgin coconut oils. First, we found that, you know, there's virgin and extra virgin. We really didn't see much of a difference in terms of the chemical composition between the extra virgin and the virgin. So you're probably just as well spending the same amount on a virgin that as an extra virgin product, not necessary to spend more for extra virgin. We did find a lot of similarity among all these products. Although we found a huge variation in cost, you can spend as little as just 7 cents to get about 8 grams of MCTs from some products, or as much as $1.68 from other products. So you definitely can do much better if you shop on the basis of cost and use our information to try to help you make that determination. The next type that we looked at were the refined coconut oils. As you can see here, it's a clear liquid. It also has kind of a nice mild coconut smell. Obviously, it's not buttery like the coconut virgin coconut oils, which have more of a semi-solid consistency. These are liquids. They can all be used in cooking. They have a smoke point that's fairly low, so in frying, it's probably not the best material to use, but you can use it in baking. These can be applied to the hair, to the skin. They can be protective of the skin. But what's really different here is with the refined coconut oils is you are removing a lot of the lauric acid, that is the longest of the medium chain fatty acids, so that you end up with a product that's about 85% of just the shorter medium chain triglycerides, caprylic and capric acids. So you're going from about 2/3 of the oil being medium chain triglycerides in a regular virgin coconut oil, although most of that is the lauric acid, to about 85% with just the two shorter chain fatty acids, caprylic and capric acid, in the refined coconut oils. And then if you want to take it a step further and you want to get rid of any kind of remaining medium chain fatty acids as well as the longer chain fatty acids, which you've gotten rid of already with the refined, is you go to the MCT oils. And here, this is where you see most variation, because they will either be mostly caprylic or a combination of caprylic and capric acids. Bulletproof, for example, is 100% caprylic acid. Others are a mixture of the two. Again, the cost will vary and range across these. So that's a kind of a quick overview of how these products differ, the medium chain triglyceride MCT products versus the amounts of MCTs in the refined and virgin coconut oils. Be aware, these are all saturated fats. The medium chain, the MCTs are 100% saturated fat. There is concern that that may raise your LDL, bad cholesterol levels. The American Heart Association advises against consuming too much of the saturated fats, even including coconut oil. Others will argue that there really isn't much evidence showing a cardiovascular negative effect from these MCT or coconut oils, which is also somewhat appears to be true. So it may raise your cholesterol. Will it really hurt you overall? Not clear at this moment. If you have any other questions, feel free to post them here where you see this video. And we encourage you to see the full report at ConsumerLab.com, where we've covered this and many other types of healthy foods and dietary supplements. Thank you very much.